You all know that the world population is growing and the demand for food is increasing rapidly, with almost 60% in 2050. But the resources, land use and things like this are scarce, so we have to produce more with less, and in there we need to have innovation.
Time does not stand still, and if we don't go move with times and take on these new ideas, think them through and have a very serious look at them, then something either may well happen or it will pass you by.
We regret that EFSA's advice will not be sought on a systematic basis. And I believe that the question was raised yesterday, but there was no answer. Indeed, the Commission will decide when to seek EFSA's advice. There are still a lot of knowledge gaps when it comes to nanotechnologies and their application in food. The mere fact that a food like insects, for instance, was consumed for many years in a third country should not be should not lead to an assumption in safety. One should also wonder about the quality of the health monitoring system in the third country in question.